Minnesota school leaders are finding that they're now the students when it comes to dealing with a teacher shortage across the state. They're trying to learn how to not only bring in teachers, but also retain them. That's because teachers are leaving at an alarming rate, with a recent report showing the number of teachers leaving their positions has increased nearly 50% since 2008. Carol Evans' Janelle Klein looks into the issue and what's being done to fix it.
Delayed.
When Janelle Voxlin FOMO first started teaching, she herself got a lesson.
Coffee's good.
Quickly learning she would not work just 40 hours a week.
Our job is not just 7 to 3.
A month into teaching middle school math,
you have to be ready to put in the hours.
Inga Dudley, too, has found her full-time job is far more than full-time.
I mean, it's a lot, and then there's the teaching, but there's the extra things on top of that that are expected.
It's a common feeling among Minnesota teachers, a fourth of which the State Department of Education says leave the field in their first 3 years.
We're seeing a mass exit out of our profession.
One reason, burnout, which a study this year by the State Department of Education showed is the top cause of teacher resignations.
That's kind of a form of mindfulness.
So much that this week's MEA conference in St. Paul has sessions on mindfulness and managing stress.
Your market status.
But the report shows Minnesota teachers are also struggling with student debt, low pay, a lack of respect, support, and mentors, combining to make what Education Minnesota now calls a crisis.
We have to fill the holes of the leaky bucket, so to speak, so that people don't leave. We want them to choose teaching, and then we want them to stay.
Leaders say that means pay raises, better funding, less paperwork, and more autonomy. All keys, they say, to not just hiring teachers, but keeping them.
I think it's time to really look for spaces and places to thank teachers on an ongoing basis.
Stress is a big reason why teachers leave, but Education Minnesota says low pay is also a factor. It says it's pushing lawmakers to come up with ways to help increase teacher salaries, saying, Randy, it is crucial to the future of our state's public education.
All right. Thank you, Janelle.